Unfortunately, we do not have a picture of the George Schalick, who emigrated from Strasbourg, France, and who was my great-grandfather. We do have this document, which states his intention to become a citizen of the United States. He was born on August 11, 1823, and this document is dated October 16, 1858, when he was 35 years old. There was no record in the Cumberland County Clerk's Office that he ever became a citizen. He died on March 8, 1874, at the age of 51. We do have this picture of George Schalick's wife, Mary A. Howe, who was born in Thun, Switzerland. We do not know when they met or when they were married. Their home was in the Roadstown area of Cumberland County, and they had four children. My grandfather, also named George, was the youngest, and was only 2 years, 10 months old when his father died as a result of a farm accident. About 2 years after her husband's death, my great-grandmother married a man by the name of Ferdinand Fritz, who was the innkeeper of the Centerton Inn. From that marriage, my grandfather gained a half-brother, Charles Fritz. My grandfather's relationship with his stepfather was not good, and he was forced to quit school at the age of 8. When my grandfather married my grandmother, his mother gave him $200 to purchase the Centerton gristmill. We do not know whether or not this was the total price. We do not know when Ferdinand Fritz died, but we do know that his widow continued to live in Centerton. My father told us that his grandmother Schalick and a grandmother Golder lived in a small cottage behind the Boyd Golder home in Centerton. She died in 1900 at the age of 64, when my father was 8. The village of Centerton, Salem County, New Jersey, was originally known as Centerville. The original village consisted of a gristmill, a sawmill, an ice house, a blacksmith shop, a wagon shop, an inn, a general store, several homes, a school, a church, and a millinery store. This is a picture of the blacksmith shop that stood along the raceway next to the store and is no longer there. The millinery shop was in a small building attached to the Heppner residence, and it is no longer there. The church was removed several years ago, although the graveyard with the Skull family is still there. And of the original village, only the inn and store and homes remain. This is a picture of the gristmill with John Hutton sitting on the log. John Hutton and Robert W. Pacey on the bridge over the raceway coming from the gristmill. Pacey lived in the house now owned by the Joseph Toy family. a 1913 view from the bridge at the dam looking toward the inn. A 1914 view of downtown Centerton, the inn and the store. The gristmill. A picture of the first truck owned by George Schalick. A postcard sent by Milton Chambers to Mary Elizabeth Campbell before she married my father. Note his drawing of her boyfriend on the roof, and also note the delivery wagon at the mill. Horse-drawn delivery wagon with my grandfather driving and my father sitting beside him. Postcard sent by my mother in 1914 to my father while he was in the German hospital for appendicitis. The hospital is now known as Lankenau. The owner of the lake and park lived in the house on the left. The Schalick homestead is in the center. Postcard sent by my father to my mother showing the new Schalick homestead. It was built when my Uncle Oakford was an infant. Note the windmill with water tank which gave the house running water in the kitchen and bathroom and a flush toilet in the bathroom. The building under the windmill was the wash house where the weekly wash was done, and the water was heated there on an oil stove. The inn. My grandfather Schalick. Harriet Lee Rourke. Same woman, but now Mrs. George Schalick. Here is my sister to tell how these two young people met.
Grandma told me that Grandpa came over to the Freesburg Lutheran Church for a church supper. She said that the minute he walked in the room, she knew that he was the one.
My grandfather, George Schalick. My father, Arthur P. Schalick. My uncle, George Schalick. My father in curls. Uncle George in curls. Uncle Earlville in curls. And again, Uncle Earlville in curls. Uncle Oakford in curls. I imagine this picture of my father was taken to commemorate the cutting of the curls. Uncle George and my father. My grandparents and their four sons on the front porch in front of the parlor door. My grandparents with Uncle Oakford and Uncle Orville. Uncle Orville. Uncle Oakford. Uncle Orville. Grandfather Schalick on the way to work. Two more pictures of my grandfather Schalick. He was all a loving and caring grandpa could be. My grandmother Schalick, a beautiful lady both inside and out, and a wonderful grandma. Two pictures of John Camel, my grandfather. My grandfather, Dr. John Camel. Lily Kiger, possibly in her wedding dress, which was red. Same woman, now Mrs. John Camel, my grandmother. My grandmother, Lily Camel. My great-grandmother, Mary McConnell Kiger. She looks like she could keep the troops in order. My great-uncle, Charles Kiger. Uncle Theodore Camel, he was a pharmacist in the Overbrook section of Philadelphia. Two more pictures of my Uncle Theodore. My mother, Mary Lizzie Camel, she changed her name to Elizabeth when she was 8. My mother. My mother with her sister Henrietta. Aunt Henrietta. My mother with her sister. My mother. Two pictures of my Aunt Henrietta. My grandfather Camel passed away on December 20, 1898, when my mother was 5 years old and her sister was 2. My grandmother later married Charles Henry Hitchner, who had 4 children by his first wife, Leroy, Charles, John, and Ellis. After their marriage, they had a son, John Merlin Hitchner, in 1908. This is a picture of my grandmother Camel Hitchner with Aunt Henrietta and Uncle John Merlin Hitchner. Grandmother Camel Hitchner with Uncle Merlin. Uncle Merlin. Uncle Merlin was a talented artist and chef and lived with us a bit while we were kids. We all enjoyed our Uncle Merlin. He was a chef and chief steward in the Merchant Marine during and after the Second World War. He was lost at sea in 1949. This is about the way he looked the last time we saw him. The following eight pictures were loaned to me by my cousin Alice Gaunt Boggs. Left to right, Aunt Dorothy Hitchner, Aunt Henrietta, Grandfather Hitchner, and the next is unknown. Cousin Alice, Aunt Henrietta, Aunt Lena Hitchner, Aunt Dorothy, Aunt Marion, wife of Uncle Merlin, and the last is unknown. My mother on the left and Aunt Henrietta on the right, the middle woman is unknown. Looks like these three beauties were trying to outdo those beautiful flowers. Two Dorothy Hitchners in the back, and on the front, my cousins Leroy and Alice Gaunt. Uncle Elmer Gaunt, Joseph Gaunt, Aunt Henrietta, Alice Gaunt, and unknown, Aunt Lena, Grandfather Hitchner, John, Uncle Roy holding Leroy, Aunt Dorothy, Aunt Marion, and Uncle Merlin. Uncle Roy Hitchner and Uncle Ellis Hitchner. Back row, Uncle Roy, Aunt Dorothy, Grandfather Hitchner, Uncle Elmer. In the center, Uncle Ellis, Aunt Dorothy, and Aunt Henrietta. In the front, cousins Alice, John, Leroy, and Joseph. Uncle Ellis Hitchner. He was a chief warrant officer in the U.S. Army. My father. My mother. Aunt Henrietta with my mother and father. My mother and father with Jenny and Bert Cole from Woodstown. Three wedding pictures of my mother and father, June 30, 1915. A sketch of the Olivet Methodist Church, replaced in 1962 by a new, larger structure. This is the church where all of us were baptized, and Uncle Orville, Uncle Oakford, and my sister were married. My sister, Harriet Lillian Schalick. Me, Arthur Pedrick Schalick, Jr. Harriet. Arthur. Harriet. Harriet and Arthur were after we each had whooping cough and chicken pox, both twice in the same year. Harriet. Harriet and her father. Harriet, Arthur, and new brother Theodore Francis Schalick. Three pictures of the three of us. Harriet looking at her father's bantams and Rhode Island red chickens. two pictures of Harriet. Uncle Oakford holding Harriet. Behind them is the house my father and his brothers were born in. It was on Dealtown Road, directly behind my home. Tom Shaw lived there for years, and it is now occupied by Earl Ward. My father with Harriet and Walter Sheard with his son Donald. The Sheards and the Schalicks. Walter Shear had a feed mill on Northeast Avenue in Vineland. Harriet and Grandmother Schalick. Harriet with her father and the delivery truck. Harriet with her new brother, me. Arthur Jr. Uncle Oakford with Harriet on his bike. Harriet and Arthur by the mill, the candle house in the background. The family car with our father, Harriet, and Arthur learning to drive. Harriet and Arthur. Arthur. Two pictures of Harriet and Arthur on the way to Grandpa and Grandma's. I wonder what was in the basket. If it was a Saturday, we were probably hoping to bring back some warm cookies. Saturday was baking day, and Grandma baked pies, bread, cakes, and cookies for the whole week. Sometimes when I can relax and my thoughts drift back, I remember walking into her kitchen on a Saturday. I can almost smell the delicious, tantalizing aroma coming from those very special molasses cookies. No one has ever been able to duplicate those molasses cookies, including my mother, who also was a fantastic baker. My sister claims she has almost duplicated Grandma's, but then I have never tasted them. Three pictures of Harriet and Arthur. My first car. A Centerton Indian. Harriet, Arthur, and Francis. Looks like a neighborhood powwow. Note the outdoor plumbing in the background. Cold and drafty in the winter and spooky at night. No wonder we all grew large bladders. Francis. Francis and Arthur. Three pictures of we three. Family outing in Atlantic City. We three. The three of us plus Harry Ward, also known as Peanut. Playing store. Uncle Ellis and Harriet and I. Uncle Ellis was my mother's stepbrother and had a career in the U.S. Army. I can distinctly remember when this picture was taken. sitting beside a real soldier was special. And he was my uncle, too. Little did I know that in the future I would be wearing that same uniform. Sunday dinner and visit at the Madeira House in Elmer with Flossie and Pearl Keene and Miss Pedrick. Indian Hot Rodder. Harriet and Arthur. The latest in swimming togs. Us three. Francis behind a bush at Grandma and Grandpa's. Arthur and Harriet behind a tree in the background. We had several family vacations in New England. Plymouth Rock, Niagara Falls, and the top of Mount Washington. Three more pictures of we three. There were several one-room grammar schools in Pittsgrove Township, now served by the Olivet and Norma schools. The Centerton one-room school, grades 1 through 8, was located on Deal Town Road just south of Clemens Road. It was converted into two apartments and burned to the ground in the late 1940s or early 1950s. Boyd Golder was the teacher there for many years. He lived on the Norma Road just opposite the Thornthwaite office. He was the teacher of my father as well as my three uncles. He also taught Harriet and was my first grade teacher. Teachers following him were Annie Eagle and Iva Woolman. Judging from where she is sitting, I would guess this picture was taken when my sister Harriet was in the seventh grade. First graders sat on the left, and as you progress across the room and to the rear, the kids and seats were bigger. Starting on the left, we can identify a few of our classmates. Front seat is Carl Harris, and the next to the last seat is Doris Ward. Second row, front to back, Stanley Prickett, Ivan Garrison, unknown, Francis Schalick, David Mitchell, Joseph Mitchell, and Harry Ward. The third row, front to back, Ruth Harris, Mildred Ward, Arthur Schalick, Bobby Cross, an unknown, Dorothy Prickett, and an unknown. And the fourth row from front to rear, Harold Kotz, his folks owned the inn, Margaret Heppner, Molly Ward, Harriet Schalick, Esther Cross, and Evelyn Harris. In the back is teacher Anna Yeagle, and two unknowns. They look like they might be eighth graders. Several graduates from these small beginnings went on to great accomplishments. Wedding party of my Uncle Orville's marriage on November 17, 1928 to Hannah Mae Miller. My mother and father and Jane Kelty. In front of Jane Kelty is me, the ring bearer. Back row is Uncle Oakford and Mame Cooper, and in the front, Uncle Orville and Aunt Hannah Mae. On the back row is an unknown woman and a friend of Uncle Orville's from Pottstown, Pennsylvania. In the front is Harriet, the flower girl, and another unknown woman. Wedding party of my Uncle Oakford's marriage on October 1, 1932 to Ethelyn M. Garrison. In the back is Reverend Charles Creamer, my father, and we believe the woman is a college roommate of the bride. In the front is Hannah Cooper and my brother Francis, the ring bearer. In the back is my Uncle Orville, Irma Garrison, and Martha Garrison. In the front is Uncle Wilfred and Aunt Ethelyn. In the back is Wilson Garrison, my mother, Evelyn Yule, and Reverend Leib. In the front is Harriet Cooper. The twins Hannah and Harriet Cooper were the flower girls. Aunt Hannah May died in 1931, a few days after childbirth. She was liked and loved by everyone, and her death was a shock to the family and the entire community. On June 10, 1933, my Uncle Orville married Evelyn Yule. Unfortunately, there is not a group picture of that wedding party. My cousin Walt was able to find this picture of the bride, his new mother. Walton Orville Schalick, Jr., with his grandmother Miller and grandmother Schalick. This picture was taken at his father's second wedding.